Hello students, from today onwards we are starting with your class 8th lesson first. Chapter name is computer virus. Okay, so I think all of you have heard about this word virus, that you speak that in your mobile phone you have virus, in your computer you have virus. So first of all, what is virus? Okay, let's discuss. A computer virus is a small software program which has replicating capabilities and is designed to spread from one computer to another. Means it is a small software program which has replicating capabilities, means it can create the copies of it again and again, and it is designed to spread from one PC to another one. That is the main disadvantage for us. You can take the example of coronavirus. It is also spreading from one person to another, same as that of your computer virus spreads from one computer to another. Okay. Now, what a virus can do? A virus can destroy files, softwares, programs, applications, and cause loss of data. Means, if your computer is infected with the virus, it can destroy your any file, any of your software, or any of the program you have installed in your computer, and you can face a loss of data. Okay, some viruses are capable of destroying all the data and information that is stored in your hard disk. You can say some viruses are very dangerous. As they enter in your computer, they have the capability to destroy all of your data. A virus may or may not be destructive. It is not compulsory that your virus is destructive always. Some viruses are meant to just steal your information. They are just created to make your PC slow or like this. Okay, so it is not compulsory that if your computer is having virus, it is destructive. Okay, and the viruses are written by programmers called virus programmers. Those who create or those who write the code to create virus are called virus programmers. Okay, so this is the complete information about your virus. Now, the full form of virus is Vital Information Resources Under Seas. This is the full form of virus. Okay, now next, what computer virus infect? First thing, viruses can infect the parts of system that are used to run programs and perform functions such as startup and shutdown. Means, if the virus enters in your computer, it may attach itself to the programs that are responsible for the startup and shutting down of your PC. Okay, second one, virus can infect program files. Program files means whenever you have made any file in Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or anything, they stick to program files such as .exe, .sys, etc. .exe means executable files. All the installation, software installation files are called .exe files, and all the files present in your system's C drive are called .sys files. Some viruses hide in the memory of a computer, while others simply attack a specific software program. And some viruses are like that, they will only attack to your specific software program like MS Word, MS Excel. Directly, they will attack the program, not the files created to it by it. Okay, viruses can create companion files that are special type of files that adds files runs on the hard disk. Means they will create, suppose any file, any of the virus enters in your PC, they will create a copy like MS Word software. So whenever you want to run your MS Word software, you will think that it is original one, but actually it is a copy, companion file of it. And whenever you run it, whenever you double click on it, you will get the virus spread starting in your PC. Okay, next topic is sources of computer virus. How your computers get viruses? There are some sources. So first one is through the internet. This is the main, you can say, number one platform by which the viruses spreads from one PC to another PC, one laptop to another laptop, one mobile to another mobile. This is a main, or you can say main number one platform by which the virus spreads itself, because nowadays nearly 90% of people are using internet. So this is the main platform. Second one is through email attachments. Have you seen that in the newspapers also, that you got a link in the email, and as you clicked on that, you will get the money deducted from your account and like this. So these are examples of email attachments through removable storage devices. This stands on the second number. Suppose you brought any pen drive from your friend, and if virus is present in that pen drive, as you plug this pen drive in your computer, you will also get the virus in your PC. Removable storage means pen drive, memory card, CD, DVD. These are called removable storage. So whenever you plug these from your friends or from any other source, you will get the virus in your PC also, if that storage is having virus. Through Bluetooth transfer. Suppose you are transferring any data from one device to another using Bluetooth, it may happen that viruses may transfer from one PC to another. Through computer network means, suppose you if we talk about any of the offices in which 20 or 30 PCs are connected together through LAN, so it may happen that the virus travels or transfers from one PC to another. Okay, now extra information. One of the first viruses to ever be identified was known as the creeper in the early 1960s. You can say this was the first virus that was created. The name of the virus is creeper, and it was created in 1960s. It was able to replicate itself and spread to other computers on the ARPANET, the earlier form of internet. Okay, so you can say the quality, or you can say the functionality of this virus is, it can replicate itself, means it can create the copies and spread from one PC to another on the ARPANET. Now what is ARPANET? The first name of the internet. Whenever the internet started in 1960s, the name was given was ARPANET, Advanced Research Project Agency Network. This was the first name of internet. So creeper was the virus that started spreading during this time. Okay, next. Now virus symptoms. How you can identify that if your virus is there in your computer? So there are some symptoms you can check. First one is, the computer runs very slow and it takes a long time to start. You can compare your new PC, and if you are using a PC from last 2-3 years, you will see a slight decrease in the speed of your PC. That is just because of the, maybe it is not compulsory, maybe your virus, your computer is infected with the virus, that's why it is running very slow. Second one, the infected file may make copies of itself, which can use all the free space in the hard disk. So if you think, I have not saved a lot of data, but my hard disk space is decreasing every day and like this, so it may be because of the virus. A copy of the virus infected files may be sent to all the addresses in your email address list. Suppose you are sending email to only one person, but your that email is sent to all the persons, those who are in your list. So it may happen just because of the virus. The virus may reformat your hard drive and delete your files and programs. There are some types of viruses that are able to delete your complete data, and they can reformat your hard disk by their own, without your knowing, without your any extra effort. Okay, so the virus may install hidden programs such as pirated software, which can be distributed and sold from your computer without your knowing. Suppose you are installing any other software, suppose you are downloading MS Office, but if the virus is there in your PC, it may install any other software, and that will be not good for your computer's health. Okay, the virus may reduce security, which may allow intruders to remotely access your computer or network. Means if the virus enters in your PC, they may allow the intruders to remotely access. Means they are, suppose I am sitting at my home and If I have sent the virus in your PC, I can access your data without your knowing. So intruder means guspetia, without knowing, jo aapke ghar mein ghus gaya hai, and like this. So window will not start because certain critical system files are missing, and then you receive an error message that lists those files. Sometimes if the virus sticks themselves to the startup files, mean the starting program files, so your computer will not be able to open, or you can say start, boot. That is also maybe just because of the virus. Okay, so these are the symptoms by which you can identify whether your PC is having virus or not. Okay, next. Now, according to their origin, techniques, according to their infections, according to their damage, we have divided the viruses into certain types. Examples are program virus, macro virus, worms, Trojan horse. These are the examples. Okay, so viruses can be classified according to their origin, techniques, types of files they infect, where they hide, the kind of damage they cause, the type of operating system or platform they attack. Given below are some most common types of viruses. Okay, so first virus is your program virus. A program virus becomes active when the program file, usually with the extension .bin, .com, .exe, .ovl, .drv, carrying the file, is opened. So program virus means these type of virus attach themselves to the program files. Program files means any of the software like .bin, .com, .exe, .ovl, .drv. So whenever you open these softwares, these viruses will get active, and once active, the virus will make copies of it and will infect other programs on the computer. That is their main purpose. Their main motto is to infect other viruses, other softwares, by making the copies of it. Okay, so these viruses usually attach themselves to the .exe files. All the softwares, whether you talk about Word, Excel, PowerPoint, MS Access, your any of the web browser, they all are the examples of .exe files. So if the virus is there in these files, they will, as you start using them, they will start making the copies. Okay, examples of program viruses are amoeba.a, acid rain, and crazy a. These are some examples of program viruses. Second, macro viruses. Now, macro viruses infect files that are created using certain applications or programs that contain macros like .doc, .xls, .pptx, .mdb, etc. First of all, I'll tell you what is macro. Macro allows you to record your frequently used work in your Word, Excel, PowerPoint. Means suppose you have to do any work daily. So on the first day, you can record it. So in the succeeding days, if you want to use it, you can just press a single shortcut key and you don't need to do that work again. Macro, simply you can say macro viruses helps you to record your work. Okay, so this thing can be done in Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and Access also. So these mini programs make it possible to automate series of operations so that they are performed as a single action. Okay, so whenever these type of virus enters in your PC, they'll try to attach themselves to the file created by Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or Access that have functionality of macro. Okay, these viruses automatically infect the files that contains macros. Examples are relax, melissa.a, bablas, and o97my2k. These are the examples of macro viruses. Okay, next are worms. A worm is a program very similar to a virus. It has the ability to self-replicate and can lead to negative effects on your computer. Means worm is also a virus, but not actually. It is a similar, you can say. It has the ability to self-replicate, means this virus can self-replicate without any user's action. Apne aap copies banana start kar dega. And can lead to negative effects on your computer. Worms generally spread through emails and networks. Means this worm generally spread through emails. Means if you are sending or receiving any email, if they have viruses or worms in their PCs, you will also get. And networks like in labs, in offices. They do not infect files or damage them. This is the good thing, that they don't infect files and they don't damage them. But they replicate so fast that the entire network may collapse. Means, suppose if you talk about any of the school lab, if the worm is there in that one PC in the network, it may travel from one PC to another. And they replicate at a very fast speed. They make the copies at a very fast speed. So it may happen that your whole network will collapse. Okay. Examples are Lovegate F, Trial C, Sobic D, and Mapson. These are the examples of worms. Okay. So that's it for today. Types of viruses is remaining. We will discuss these in the second part of this video. Okay. Till then, you have to read this properly. This is an important topic. Okay. Thank you.